Hello, I'm John Smizer. I'm a pastor here in the Southern California area, and it's a joy to come and spend time with you as we look into God's Word. Living life, that's a wonderful part of our journey together. I'm getting ready here for a little bit of preparation because we're getting ready, my wife and I, to take a trip up to visit some family up in the Seattle, Washington area. So we're having to get our accommodations ready, get our bags packed and everything. And we're having to just really get ready for, this is kind of the vacation time here in America that we spend time traveling, looking at new sites and everything. And I don't know if you remember the movie Kindergarten Cop. It was Arnold Schwarzenegger was a undercover in a little town up in Oregon called Astoria. Well, that's where our family's going to meet together on a little hotel, motel place out on the beach there in the Astoria area and just spend time together. I'm looking forward to taking a kite with my granddaughter and flying it out by the ocean. A little frisbee, my grandson got, but he's only 1 year old, so I don't know if he's going to be able to throw it. But just spending the time with family, and there's a sense in which preparations need to take place. And I don't know if in your life that right now there's that preparation for anything just in the future, but I know that God's going to guide us today as we prepare to look into God's Word. So God bless you as we look into Leviticus chapter 8 today.
Leviticus chapter 8, verses 1 through 9. The Lord said to Moses, "Bring Aaron and his sons, their garments, the anointing oil, the bull for the sin offering, the two rams, and the basket containing bread made without yeast, and gather the entire assembly at the entrance to the tent of meeting." Moses did as the Lord commanded him, and the assembly gathered at the entrance to the tent of meeting. Moses said to the assembly, "This is what the Lord has commanded to be done." Then Moses brought Aaron and his sons forward and washed them with water. He put the tunic on Aaron, tied the sash around him, clothed him with the robe, and put the ephod on him. He also fastened the ephod with a decorative waistband which he tied around him. He placed the breastpiece on him and put the Urim and Thummim in the breastpiece. Then he placed the turban on Aaron's head and set the gold plate, the sacred emblem, on the front of it, as the Lord commanded Moses.
Here in Leviticus chapter 8, we're looking at verses 1 through 9, and there's some instructions that Moses receives from the Lord. And it's a time when they're getting ready to ordain, to set apart, to establish the priesthood through Aaron. And there's a section here that I think is just very special in the idea of, as I shared earlier, preparation to go to be with my children. There's a time here of preparation, the instructions God gives Moses. In verse 2 here it says, "Bring Aaron and his sons, their garments, the anointing oil, the bull for the sin offering, the two rams, the baskets containing the bread made without yeast, and gather the entire assembly at the entrance of the tent of meeting." There you're getting ready for a great celebration, a great event here. And it's Moses' role, his responsibility, pull all these elements together. And so God is intentional when he sets forth an idea of preparation, and that we don't just happen to have an event. We don't just happen to do things. No, God sets before us that step-by-step preparation. In this situation, It is for the ordination of his priesthood. The priesthood is though are those who will take the concerns, the heart of the people, and share that with the Lord. They will take on behalf of the people in the future sacrifices, gifts, whatever the elements, the priests are the ones to take them to the Lord. So they are their intermediary, the one who stands between God and the people. That's what the priest's role is. And then later on here in verse 6, we recognize there's a particular part that takes place in the role that the priest plays and who they are, when in verse 6 it says, "Then Moses brought Aaron and his sons forward and washed them with water, cleansed them, took away all the dust and dirt and all the stuff that's around them that would hold on to them from the desert. They're to be washed clean of that. They're not to be encumbered with or have those muddy marks all over them." And I love that in Ephesians chapter 5, it talks about how in our lives, the Word of God is that which washes us clean. You know, it's kind of like taking a bath regularly. Whenever we come to God's Word, whenever we look into His Word, we recognize that the Holy Spirit's using it to wash our lives. And in that same way, in preparation to have that go-between between the people and God, those folks needed to be cleansed, washed clean. And I know there's a lot more we can say about that, but I want to jump down a little bit to this next portion in verse 7. It says, "He put the tunic on Aaron, tied the sash around him, clothed him with a robe, and put the ephod on him. He also fastened the ephod with a decorative waistband, which he tied around him. He placed the breastplate on him. He put the Urim and the Thummim in the breastplate. Then he placed the turban on Aaron's head and set the gold plate and sacred emblem on the front of it, as the Lord commanded him." Boy, he's dressed for success now. He's dressed for the job he's going to have to do. My mind, when I read this, I'm drawn particularly to the clothing that a Christian needs to be wearing. Because as we go forth every day to work, to school, to spend time with friends or wherever, we get dressed up in some ways. You know, if you're going outside to work on the garden, you get dressed up a certain way. If you get ready to go to a fancy dinner, oh boy, you get dressed a different way. But in the life of a Christian, there is such an important role that being dressed properly needs to take place. And I'm referring again into the book of Ephesians, chapter 6, when it talks about putting on the full armor of God. This element that is Aaron and his sons are going to be the go-between God and the people. So when we are that in that role to be that go-between, there are certain elements that are important. The belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, shod our feet or stand in the gospel that we know, the shield of faith, the sword of the word, and the helmet of salvation. Those things need to be very critically part of our wardrobe. So that reminds me in my life, how am I dressed? Am I prepared to do God's work? When we talk about the idea of preparation, when we consider the idea that we need to be ready and God gives us the direction of what we should be doing, in that, when I talked about the armor of God, some people think, well, when I'm going to get into a battle, I'll get ready for the battle then. No, We need to be preparing every day, every hour, for the battle that lays ahead. So when we talk about the idea of truth, righteousness, the assurance of the gospel, our faith, the use of our offensive tool, the sword of the word, and then the realization that our elements are protected by the helmet, that needs to begin, folks, today. We need to be ready and start wearing that armor today, not wait for the future. Let's call on God to prepare us and guide us in that. Father God, today we thank you that you are our Heavenly Father and you are the one that has instructed us and given us the tools. We thank you for your word that builds us up every day. We thank you for the devotion of living life together as it guides us into an understanding of what you would have us be like, act like, wear. What's our clothing, Lord? What should people see in our lives? Lord, I pray today that in my life, Lord, in our lives, you would be happy. You would smile at what we are wearing, and we would truly follow you in all ways. In your precious name, amen.
This program is 시청자 여러분의 소중한 후원으로 제작됩니다.